गुड मॉर्निंग, आई एम डॉक्टर नीतू शर्मा एंड आई हेड द ऑफ्थेल्मोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट एट फोर्टिस हॉस्पिटल नोएडा. आई वुड लाइक टू स्टार्ट विद द चिल्ड्रन हियर. इंश्योर दैट योर चाइल्ड गेट्स एन आई चेकअप डन एटलीस्ट बाय द टाइम ही इज 4 ईयर्स ऑफ एज. इफ देर इज अ स्ट्रॉन्ग फैमिली हिस्ट्री ऑफ ग्लासेस इन योर केस, देन मेक श्योर दैट ही स्टार्ट्स गेटिंग हिज चेकअप्स एज सून एज यू आर एबल टू गेट हिम टू द ऑफ्थेल्मोलॉजिस्ट. समटाइम्स दिस कैन बी एज अर्ली एज 1 ईयर ऑफ एज. If you notice a squint in your child's eyes, then again, rush him to the ophthalmologist. I'm not saying this is an emergency, but this is one condition where your squint can be controlled with something as simple as a correct eyeglass. Very often, a lazy eye in a child can be prevented with a timely eye checkup. If your child has been diagnosed with a lazy eye and he is not yet turned 9 to 10 years of age, he's a younger child, then you can very often treat this lazy eye with something as simple as an occlusion of one eye. The other thing you need to know when you go to an ophthalmologist, be mentally prepared for a dilated eye checkup. Very often we have patients who are not aware that a complete eye checkup includes a dilation of the pupil, which requires instillation of dilating eye drops, and for the patient to wait in the waiting area for 1/2 hour to 1 hour and then get a complete refraction and a retina checkup done. The thing that you need to know here is that after dilatation, you may not be able to drive for a very long distance. The sun is going to be hurting your eye even more, and your vision for near is going to be a little blurred. As long as you're okay with these things for the day and you don't have a very busy day, it's advisable to ask your doctor to do a dilated eye checkup. If you're a diabetic, ensure that you get a retina checkup done six monthly to one yearly. If you already have a diabetic retinopathy, make sure that it's a six monthly checkup. If your retinas have been diagnosed to be normal, then you can go in for a 1 yearly checkup. If you're a hypertensive, likewise, an annual to a two-yearly retina checkup is extremely important. A little word of caution about over-the-counter medicine use in our country. Very often we have patients who have a redness in the eye going to the chemist and asking for an eye drop, and they do get an eye drop from the chemist. Now, while we don't really blame the chemist in this, I think this practice has to be stopped both ways, from the patient side and from the chemist side, because very often a red eye could range from an infection to an inflammation to anything, and the treatment for these two conditions would be absolutely opposite. In one condition we need to give antibiotics, and in the other condition we need to give steroid drops. And a condition like this cannot be diagnosed unless you have an eye surgeon look at you on the slit lamp. The last and a very important point for children is that when they're studying, make sure that they are holding the book at a good distance. If your child is holding the book too close to his eyes, there is a chance that he's a myope, or he has a minus number in his eyes which has gone undiagnosed, or he has fallen into this habit of holding the book too close to his eyes. Either way, he needs to be told to hold the book at the correct distance, and he needs an eye checkup. And whenever he's studying, ensure that he has an overhead light also, as well as a table lamp, which is not casting a shadow onto his books.